So you want to learn how generics work in Swift, but you don't have a lot of time? In just a few minutes, we'll go over everything you need to understand how this powerful feature works. Let's start with this piece of code. As you can see, I've implemented a data structure to store integers in a stack. However, I can only store integers inside this stack, meaning that if I want to store, for instance, strings, I will need to implement a new version of my stack. And it will be the same thing if I want to store a custom type in my stack. Of course, this approach is not scalable at all, and we would like to have a mechanism to define a single stack that would work with any kind of values. And as you can imagine, this is where generics come into play. So let's go back to my stack of integers. I'm going to modify my code to introduce a generic type called element. This generic type can be seen as a type argument that we will pass to the stack to let it know which type it can store. Now, all that's left to do is to actually use the generic type element inside the implementation of the stack. And we can finally use our generic type to store different types of elements in our stack. That's it, we've covered the basics of how generics work in Swift. Thanks to this feature, we were able to define a single type that will be able to work with different types of values depending on the generic type we provided. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Remember to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss the next one. Thank you for watching and see you next time.